In today's lecture, we are going to study cross-stop survey. In the previous lecture, we have seen what is the use of cross-stop, and we can use that cross-stop to locate the perpendicular. Now, what is cross-stop survey? What is the object of cross-stop survey? The object of cross-stop survey is to locate the boundaries of the field or a plot and determine its area. Means if we have to determine the area of any field or any plot, we have to use the cross-stop survey. What is the principle behind? How do we find out the area by using cross-stop survey? How we determine the area of triangle? We know the, what is the formula for area of triangle. If this is the triangle, this is the base and this is the height, then area is equal to base into height into half. Okay, that is half base into height. So, this is the one principle to determine the cross-stop survey, and second is area of the trapezoid. If there is some trapezoid like this, we know two sides of the trapezoid are parallel, and if we have to determine the area of this trapezoid, let its sides be h1 and h2, and let the base be B. So, how do we determine area of this trapezoid? It is equal to base into half sum of the heights. Okay, so what is the principle on which this cross-stop survey is based? That is, the area of right angle triangle is equal to base into half the perpendicular, and the area of the trapezoid is equal to base into half the sum of perpendiculars. So, how do, by using these just two simple principles, we determine the area by cross-stop survey? So, here what we do, whenever we have to determine, suppose this is any field, and we have to determine its area. So, what we do, very first step, we will run the chain line in the middle of the area. Whatever the area or the plot or a field of which we have to determine the area, what we will do, we first run the chain line from the center of the area. Then we locate the boundaries of the area by ranging rod. We locate the boundaries like this. Here we can locate the boundaries such that we can convert this area. As you can see, this is the one at random area. What we are doing? We are just fixing the boundaries of this area. Okay. So, we are fixing the boundaries of the area. Now, we have fixed the ranging rod. How we are fixing the boundaries of the area? So that we can divide this area into triangle and the trapezoid. We can divide this area into triangles and the trapezoid. So, you can see here, if we locate this perpendicular, this is the one triangle. If we locate this perpendicular, another second figure we are getting as a trapezoid. If we are taking this third offset, then if we are locating third offset, again we are getting the third figure as a trapezoid. Again this fourth figure, we can consider it as a trapezoid. Again, we can consider the one trapezoid, fifth figure. As we are taking, what we are doing? We are just taking the perpendicular offset of the boundaries. Okay, so that we can divide this area into triangles and the trapezoid. Again, this you can see that this can be we can convert it as a triangle. Again, this is another. We can consider it as a trapezoid. Again, we can consider this area as a trapezoid, and last one we can consider it as a triangle. So we are converting, suppose this is another triangle which is left, we are converting this area into triangles and the trapezoids. What is the first step? If we have to determine the area of any
hint or any plot, we first run a chain link in the middle of that area. Then we fix the boundaries along boundaries of that area, and then we take the offset along that boundaries, and so that we can easily convert it into triangles and the trapezoid. Once we convert this area into trapezoids and triangle, just by using these two principles, that area of triangle is equal to, if this is the base, now we can see this is the base for this triangle, and this we can consider as a height. For this trapezoid, we can consider this is the base, and these two are the heights. So by using these two principles, area of triangle is equal to base into half the height, or base into half the perpendicular, and area of trapezoid is equal to base into sum of perpendiculars divided by 2. Just by using this simple geometrical formulas for determining area, we will find out area of each figure, and by summing up all the area, we will get the area of complete field. Got it? What is the Krostov survey? In Krostov survey, we will convert the area into triangles and trapezoids, and by using simple geometrical formulas for finding area of triangle and finding area of trapezoid, we will find the area of each figure, and after summing up all the areas, we will get the area of this complete area or complete plot or complete field. Okay, so let us solve a numerical so that you will get the clear idea of this Krostov survey. This is one numerical. A page of a field book of a Krostov survey is given in the figure. This is the page of the field book. Okay, in the figure, plot the required figure and calculate the relevant area. Now, we have done one survey to calculate the area of some plot, some field. So, these are the entries in the field book, and from that, we have to calculate its area. So, what are these? These are the changes written in the center, 0, 20, 40, 65, 90, 110. These are the changes. These will act as a base of a, let it be triangle or trapezoidal, to find out the area. And these are the offsets of various points on the boundary. This is point C at an offset of 42 meter, E at a 58, D at a distance of 20 meter, and F at a distance of 60 meter. So now we have to find out the area of this field from this readings. So very first step, we have to draw the figure. So while drawing figure, we can start with any, this is the A and this is the B. Let us start with the point A. Okay, so here this is the point A of chain H, 0. Okay, from that, if we are moving from A to B, then these readings are at the left hand side and these are at the right hand side. Okay, so we first our reading is at right hand side at the chain edge of 20, and what is that? And what is that one? C, and what is this offset? It's a 42 meter. C at the distance of 42 meter. Okay, then next is D at the chain edge of 40. This is the chain edge 40. At the chain edge of 40, we have D at a distance of 20 meter. It is at the left hand side D, C was at the right hand side. So here we can write it as a D, point D, and what is its offset? It's a 20 meter. Okay. Then next is again toward the right hand side E, which is at the offset of, which is at the chain edge of 65 meter. The chain edge for AD is 65 meter. And what is this offset? Its offset is 58 meter. So here we can write down the point E at the offset of 58 meter. Okay. And the next point is F at the chain edge of 90. Let this be the chain edge 90. And what is its offset? 60 meter. Okay, so at the 60 meter, it is point F at the offset of 60 meter. Got it? And then last one is here the end B, and which is, this is our change zero, and this point is A, and this point is B, and what is change 110 meter. Okay, got it? So now we can join it to form this figure. This is one triangle. This will form one trapezoid. This will form one triangle. Okay. Again, this will form one triangle. This will form one trapezoidal, one trapezoid. And here the last figure is again the triangle. Okay. So what we did, we have drawn the figure based on this field booking trick. Whatever the offsets are at the left hand side, we have written it on the left hand side, and whatever are there on the right hand side, we have written it on the right hand side. So we got this figure here. We have converted this, it is a triangle, trapezoidal, and again triangle. Like that, we got this figure. Now we can number it. Okay, like again, we can give. Now we have to convert into triangle, so we need here, we can give the names for this basis. Now sir, A, B, C, D, E, F is the last. We can give a G, H, I, and J. We can write it as a suffix. So this will become triangle A, C, G. This will become triangle A, D, H. Like that, we can name this figure. Okay. So now what is the next step? We have to make one table. Here we can form this table. This table format will be always same. This is a typical format, and we have to use same format every time. So here first number is, first column is serial number, then figure, then change, then base, next is offset, then next is mean offset, and last is area. Okay, so here we can give the numbers to the figures like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so now we'll see one by one. What is the serial number 1, figure number 1? What is figure? That is, this is triangle AGC. Okay, this is triangle AGC. Okay, now see, this is triangle AGC. Next is chain edge. Okay, what is this chain edge? Its starting change is 0 meter, and from this triangle, see, we are considering now this triangle AGC, this triangle, okay, triangle AGC, okay. So change, now we have, first we have write down the name of the figure, that is triangle AGC. Then change means this is the base of this triangle. Okay, so at what change it is starting and what change it is ending. So this figure, this triangle, this base starts at the chain edge 0 and it ends at chain edge 20. So here chain edge will come as a 0 and 20. Okay, now we got the starting chain edge of the base, starting point of this base, and end point of this base. So now we have to determine the base. So base will be this end point, end chain edge minus starting chain edge. So it will become basis. This 20 minus 0. So what is the is base? Base will get as a 20 meter. Then next is offset. Okay. So this is triangle. Okay. So what are its offset here? If we consider this, this is base. What is the starting offset? It's a here, it is 0, and then next is 42. 0 and 42. So what is mean offset? We have to take the mean of these two, 0 and 42. That mean will come 0 plus 42 divided by 2, that is 21. Now here it should come in your mind why we have considered here the 0. Okay, and why we are taking mean here. So what is the formula for area of triangle? Half into base into height Okay, so base we got here just by subtracting this last chain is minus first chain is. Okay, here we got the base. Then height, what is the height of this triangle? It is the just offset, that is, what is its offset? 42 meter. So height of this triangle is 42. Now we have to incorporate this half. So what we are doing, we are taking the mean of two heights to take the make the effect of half. What we are doing, we are taking the mean of these two, means this two offset, means this is zero, though we know triangle this will always become big zero, one offset will always zero and another offset means it is the height, that is 42. Okay, so to take the effect of this half, we are considering one offset as a zero here, because here it has no height. If it has some height, it will become trapezoid. बरोबर म्हणजे काय झालं असतं, जर आपण हा झिरो काबार घेतोय, हा ट्रायंगल इथे इथे कोणताच ऑफसेट नसतं, पण आपल्याला हाफ करायचंय मीन, मग हाफ करायसाठी आपल्याला काय करायला लागेल, मीन घ्यावं लागेल. तर आपण काय करतो, झिरो प्लस 42 डिवाइड बाय 2 म्हणजेच 21. ओके, अँड व्हॉट इज फॉर्म्युला? हाफ बेस इन टू हाईट. ओके, सो दिस टू टेक दिस कम्प्लीट फॉर्म वी हॅव टू टेक द मीन हाईट फॉर. म्हणून ते मीन हाईट घ्यायसाठी आपण काय करतो, पहिला ऑफसेट आहे ट्रायंगलचा झिरो कन्सिडर करतो आणि नेक्स्ट जे ऑफसेट जी काही हाईट आहे ती घेतो आणि त्यावरून आपण मीन ऑफसेट घेतो. मीन ऑफसेट घेतलं की आपल्याला केलं हा हाफ साईड इफेक्ट याला हाफ इंटू हाईट, दॅट इज विल गेट 21. ट्रॅपेझॉइडच्या वेळी असं करायची काही गरज नाही, बिकॉज ट्रॅपेझॉइड व्हाईल फॉर ट्रॅपेझॉइड देर इज नो नीड टू टेक एनी ऑफसेट, बिकॉज ट्रॅपेझॉइड हॅज अ ऑलरेडी इट हॅज टू ऑफसेट. सपोज दिस इज द फिगर टू, इट इज ट्रॅपेझॉइड, यू कॅन सी हियर दिस इज वन ऑफसेट अँड अनदर. This is another offset. It has already two offset. What is the area of trapezoid? Base into half of sum of perpendiculars. Means these are two perpendicular and we have to take the half of that into base. So to take the half of that, we have to take the mean of these two offsets. That's why here the mean offset is there. Okay. So trapezoid has already two offset. So we can consider it here directly two offset. But triangle has only one offset. So another offset we are considering here as a zero. Got it? So we got the here in the first figure, we got the mean offset as a 21. This is 0 plus 42 divided by 2, 21. So here, what is the area? We have the formula here, base into mean offset. What is the base? That is 20 into 21. 20 into 21. So our area will be 20 into 21. 4, 2, 0. Got it? Base into mean offset. Okay. Now let us consider the second figure. What is the second figure? Second figure is a trapezoid. And what is this? It's a CGIE. 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 Okay. What is C? This is the second figure. Okay. Figure number 2. And what is C, G, I, E? This is second figure. Okay. So now we are considering this figure. Okay. So see here, change from which, from what change this figure starts? It is starting with the change 20. Okay. See here, it is starting with the change 20. And where it is finishes? It is finishes at a change 65. So here we can write here 20 and 65. Okay, this is starting at the chain 20, this is ending at the chain 65. Got it? So this is chain 20 and 65. So what is the base? Base means this, what is the base? It is, we are getting 65 minus 20. 65 minus 20. So here we are getting base as a 45 meter. Okay, now let us move for the offset. Here, this is our figure, second figure. And what are its offset? One offset is this one, another offset is this one. Okay, so what is this offset? The first offset is of, it's 42, and second offset 58. So here we can directly write 42 and 58. One offset is 42 and another is 58. So let us take mean of these two, it will become 50. So here mean offset is 50. And now what is the area? For area we have to multiply base into mean offset. Okay, it will come 2250. Got it? What we are doing? It is base into mean offset. Base here will directly get by subtracting net change from previous point change, that is 65 minus 20. We are getting 45, 65 minus 20, and offset, one offset is 42, another offset is 58. And to take the effect of pop, we are taking mean of these two is 50. By multiplying base into mean offset, we are getting area of this second figure. Now what we are doing, we are one by one calculating area of each figure. Okay. Then we consider figure number 3. What is figure number 3? Figure number 3 is IBE, that is triangle IBE. Okay, this one figure number 3. Now we are considering this figure, last figure. Okay, IBE. So what is the starting change? The starting change, where it is starting? We see your base of this triangle is this. Well, what is the starting point of this base? 65, and end point is 110. So here we can write here change as a 65 and 110. 65 and 110. Then what is the base? It is the 110 minus 65. We'll get here directly base. 65 minus 110 means 45. And what is its offset? Again, now we can see here one offset is 58 and is a triangle, so another offset we have to consider it as a 0. What is the offset? 58. This is one offset 58 and another is 0 as it is triangle. We don't have offset on the other end of the base, so we can write here 58 and 0. Then what is the mean offset? 0 plus 58 divided by 2, that is 29. Then calculate area, that is base is 45 into mean offset 29. Okay, calculate this. Okay, so let us consider the next figure, that is figure number 4. What is the figure number 4? It is the triangle FJB. This is triangle FGB. Now we are considering this figure number 4. This figure, triangle F, J, and B is last one. Can you see this F, J, B? Last one. And next, right here, triangle F, J, B. Okay. So, where it is starting? What is the starting point of this base of this triangle? 90. And where it is ending? 110. See, this figure starting from 90 and ending at 110. So what is the change? 90 and 110. Okay, so what is difference? 20. This is 20. Then see here offsets. What are the offsets of this figure? See here, one offset is 60 and another as it is triangle. So another offset will be 0. So what are its offsets? 60 and 0. 60 and 0. So here the mean offset is 60 plus 0 divided by 2, that is 30. Okay, so here area is equal to base into mean offset, that is 20 into 30, 600. This is the area. Next is figure number 5. What is figure number 5? It is a trapezoid. It is HDFJ. What is figure? This is our fifth figure now. We are considering this figure as the HDFJ. HDFJ. Okay. So, what is starting point of this figure? What is 40 and 90. This figure starts from 40 and ends at 90. 40 and 90. Okay, so 40 and 90. So what is the base? We'll get 90 minus 40, that is 50. Next is offset. So this is, what is the offset for this fifth figure? One is 20, another is 60. So here we can write here 20 and 60. And what is mean offset? 20 plus 60 divided by 2, that is 40. Okay, so what is the area? This 2000. Okay, so here now the last figure, that is figure number 6. And what is it? It is this triangle. This is triangle ADH. This triangle, triangle ADH. This is the last figure. Now, this is the last figure, triangle ADH. Okay. So, what is this base? This is, it's starting from 0 and ending at 40. So it is 0 and 40. So what is the value of base? 40 minus 0, that is 40. Next, then what is the offset here? For this triangle, one offset is 0 and another is 20. So we can write here 0 and 20. And what is the mean offset? It is the mean of the two offset, 0 and 20, that will be 10. 0 and 10, mean offset will be 10. So what will be the area? 40 into 10, that is 400. Got it? 40 into 10, 400. So now we have calculated the area of each figure. Now we have calculated the area of each figure. And to get the area of whole this figure, we have to sum up all these area. We have to take the sum of all these area. It is coming as a 6975. Sum of all the areas, 6975 meter square. Okay. So, how do we find out area of the figure? We have to first draw the diagram. We have to draw first figure of the given data, that is, we are getting it in the form of triangles and trapezoids. We have to number it, all the figure, and we have to make the tabular format. And in this tabular format, if we follow this tabular format, there is no chance of making mistake. We have to consider figure one by one, and we have to keep in the mind what is starting point and end point, because there are also middle entries are there. So always concentrate on the complete figure, where it is starting and where it is ending. Again, offset, and there is only one small doubt you may get for why we are considering two offset for the triangle, that I have explained to you. Okay, so here this is the small numerical. It will clear your idea how to do the cross talk survey and to determine the area of any field or plot will